ready to go.
1984 was a special year in Damascus.
They know what it takes to win, and we hope that we're able to keep doing that.
The Holston football and boys basketball teams won the outright Hokohegie District Championship, but they haven't won it since, until 2021.
It felt good to get our names out there, really, and so people know us as like a group. That we did it together.
On the hardwood, the Cavs made history, winning the district regular season and tournament titles.
Like, us players here, winning that, it feels like you're a celebrity, really. Like, everybody comes up to you and talks to you and, like, respects you. It feels good.
So when Quaheem Brooks and company eventually lost in the state quarterfinals and transitioned to the football season, they brought more history with them, winning the district in football, too.
This is the best team I've ever been on, really. Funnest team, we all got a bond, like we could joke around and have fun. I like this team.
You know, our basketball team did it first, and of course Q and quite a few of those other guys, Bryson and Lane and Ethan and Trent, you know, they were all a part of that as well, the basketball team and winning that district title, and then for us to do it in football is really special.
Quaheem, they call him Q, is the quarterback, but doesn't look like it when you see the electric plays he makes with his feet.
It helps me a lot because they don't know what I'm going to do. It's like when I roll out the pocket, the receivers think I'm gonna run, so they come down here real quick, and then I can throw it, dump it off. But if they stay back, I can run. So it's really like it's tough to play us, really.
He's always kind of had that that natural ability to move and change directions, but maybe not that straight line speed, and that's kind of come along with it as he's gotten older. And you know, it's kind of amazing some of the plays that he's made this year.
But then he drops back and shows off the arm that's helped lead the Cavs to a trip to the region championship game.
So hard this summer, that's all I did really was throw. I didn't really work on my agility, but I worked on my arm to get better at that.
And that's probably where his work ethic has helped him the most, is his ability to throw the ball. He's kind of has a little bit of a natural arm talent, but to coach him up on different types of fundamentals of playing that position, I think our coaches have done a really good job with that.
That's number three, Quaheem Brooks.
When looking at what this team has already accomplished, you can see all the hard work they've put in. A process that started a year ago.
Now, they go.
Working with these guys, like we used to meet up every day in the summer and just throw routes all day. And now I get tired of it, and that really helped me. That's all we talked about, really. We'd come here and throw, and go to someone's house and just hang out and just talk about what we're gonna do and like lift and stuff. We wanted this to be the best season, probably. We won the ring.
When we were shut down during the summer and we were not allowed to work together as a team, those kids got together and they threw and they ran routes. And of course, you know, coaches weren't allowed to be involved, but you know, they told us, hey, we're working out, we're grinding, you know, we're trying to get better, and it's shown.
The season finally came around, pushed back to the spring. The Cavs were as confident as anyone, but a loss to start the season was a moment for Q and the rest of the team to look at themselves in the mirror.
And we didn't execute, so we lost that game. But he personally messaged me and said, Coach, I'm sorry, we're gonna get it fixed. We shouldn't have lost that game. And they've worked hard to fix it. They've been more focused, they've been more determined.
That was like my first time showing leadership, I feel like, this season. Like, I was goofing off and stuff before, and then after that loss, it hit me like I gotta get serious, so you get the other guys serious. Then it worked.
Quaheem has been through a number of learning experiences off the field, especially during his time in the foster care system. He's from Asheville, North Carolina. He stayed in a home elsewhere in Southwest Virginia for a couple years before him and his brother were adopted by a family here in Damascus.
A lot of people don't really know his story, but you know, he has a really special story, as a lot of kids do, but to see what he's gone through and how he's overcome it and the way that he's progressed and the way he's moving forward, you know, if he can keep his head on straight and he can continue to work hard and be motivated by the things that have gone on in life and the goals that he wants to achieve, you know, the sky really is the limit for him.
I kind of liked it, because if I didn't move here, I don't know if I'd be playing football. I'd probably be somewhere else, I don't know. So this really gave me a good opportunity to showcase this and be able to get in college, really.
Now, after his senior year, he's ready for that next step in his education and in his career. He doesn't have any scholarship offers yet, but he wants to keep playing football.
I want to play bad. I want to play. That's what I really wanted. My goal is really this summer, I want to do the same thing, start throwing more, work on my agility, and I'm going to start lifting a lot more.
He's a special young man, and he's a good player, and he's ultra competitive, and I think that will help him to work hard and succeed in the at the college level, both as a student and as an athlete. And like I said, he's not one of those kids who's like, oh, I want to play quarterback. No, it's not like that. He just wants an opportunity to play.
In Damascus, Michael Epps.
Down. There you go.
News Channel 11 Sports.